Peak Pro is a registered trademark of Bias Incorporated, and I am in no way affiliated with Bias Incorporated. In this lesson, I'm going to be teaching you about some of the advanced editing functions in Peak Pro. If you want to make sure that you have your cursor selected, and I'm going to select the beginning drumbeat part of my song. If I come up to Edit and come down to Crop, what that's going to do is it's going to crop my selection, which shouldn't be confused with the zoom function, because what happens is it's going to delete everywhere in my song except for where I had my selection at. So I'm going to go ahead and undo that and zoom back in here. Also, if I come up to Edit and select Silence, what that's going to do is it's going to fill up my selection with silence, and this shouldn't be confused with the insert silence. I'm going to undo that and come back up to Edit and select Insert Silence, and it's going to ask you how many seconds of silence you want. I'm going to leave it at 1 and click OK, and it's going to insert silence before where I had my selection at there. So I'm going to go ahead and undo that. I'm going to remake my selection here, and if I come up and copy that, and I'm going to select the end there, and if I come up to Edit and select Duplicate, what that's going to do, it's going to ask me how many times I want that duplicated. If I select, I'm going to select 5, that's going to copy that 5 different times, so now I've got a total of 6 copies of the drum beat there. One last thing is if I make a selection here, and I'm going to copy that as well and come to another part of my song. Come to another part of my song and make a selection there. If I select Edit and click Replace, what that's going to do is it's going to paste my selection there, but it's going to overwrite where I had my selection at. So those are some of the advanced functions available to you in Peak Pro.